get started here. Upcoming board meetings, December 11th, 2017, regular meeting at the Mentone Elementary at 7 p.m. January 15th, 2018, regular meeting, Burkitt Education Center, 7 p.m. And February 12th, 2018, regular meeting at the Tippecanoe Valley Middle School at 7 p.m. We'll move on to Spotlight on the Valley.
Okay, thanks, Todd. We always like to welcome and introduce new employees to the board. We have one with us tonight that I'd like to introduce to you, and that's Pam Wainscott. Pam is the new treasurer at Mentone Elementary School, but she's not new to Tippecanoe Valley.
No.
Now, Pam, you were telling me you've been here how long?
Off and on since 89.
Since 1989. You've done what during that time for us?
Para. I was study hall back when 7th and 8th grade were here. I have done special education, substitute taught for numerous years. Now, I'm back.
So, welcome. We're glad to have you as our treasurer here. Mm-hmm. And that's all for that.
Okay, on to the next one. Pillar Award of Outstanding Support Staff.
Yeah. We like to periodically recognize some folks in our district for a couple of reasons. One would be the what we call the Pillar Award for Outstanding Support Staff. And these are folks who, among our classified staff, that work very hard and receive very little recognition. And we then recognize those folks in our From the Heart of the Valley newsletter. This go around, we have two that we'd like to honor. The first is, what's this? Open that up. Dawn Rowland. And Dawn is not here with us tonight, but we'd like to say a few words about her. You can see up on the screen information that was provided for us. And Dawn was married in October to Dan Norris, so it's now Dawn Rowland Norris. And Dawn says it's the people that she'll miss the most working as the secretary at the Tippecanoe Valley School Corporation. She was with us since 1990 as the secretary receptionist at the administration office there. So 27 years in that particular position. And we certainly hated to see Dawn go, but she's helping out with her husband's business, working on their farm, painting, and doing some more things with her family. So I'd like to wish Dawn all the best and recognize her as one of our Pillar Award winners. Now we have a second Pillar Award winner tonight, Audrey Suming. And we'd ask Audrey if she would please come on up front. Mr. Hoffman has a framed certificate he'd like to present to her. And here's what Mr. Leedy put together for Mrs. Suming. Says, Audrey Suming says, as long as she can remember, she has always wanted to work with kids. The Tippecanoe Valley Middle School paraprofessional calls it an honor to receive the Pillar Award for Outstanding Support Staff. Audrey's been working at the middle school for 14 years and currently assists 8th grade students and teachers with their coursework and lesson plans. I could be having a horrible morning, come in here, and it just perks me up. It reminds me, this is why I do what I do, she said. Audrey loves working with middle school students because they still have a youthful side, but are also starting to mature into young adults. She also enjoys keeping up with her former students after they graduate. Sometimes wonder about the kids you've taught and how they're doing, how they're going to do in life. It's just amazing to see when they go on to do great things. Audrey also stays active in the community. She donates blood, has served on the Jack and Jill Preschool Board, and contributes to the United Way and helps with school fundraisers. So, Audrey, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank
and
you.
Is there anything you'd like to share with the board? Or
pretty much says it right there. I just really enjoy working with
Mr. Backus sent me a text this afternoon. He wanted to be here tonight to see you honored, but he wasn't feeling too well, so he stayed home because of that. But congratulations and thank you very much for all you do for us.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you.
Okay.
Should I hold up the one?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. One, two.
two, three. One, two, three.
Two. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're right out there, Todd. Next, we'd like to recognize our world-class teacher, and that is June Yates. June, come on up, please. And while she's coming up here, I'll read with you what Mr. Lee put together after speaking with her. Says June Hazel enjoys seeing her students progress and get excited about learning. I think Tippecanoe Valley has a lot of great offerings for the kids, and I'm proud to be part of it, she said. The TVHS instructor came to Tippecanoe Valley in 1990 and has been chosen to receive the World Class Teacher Award. June currently teaches political and economic studies, along with two English 12 classes and driver's ed. She's also taken on several roles outside of the classroom by coaching divers on the high school swim team, serving as vice president of the Teachers Association, and managing the high school's Facebook page. June helps coach the academic team and also helps operate Tees Boutique, a donation-based store inside the school that lets students borrow dress clothes for special occasions. Muncie, Indiana native, says education at Tippecanoe Valley is more personal than the larger school she attended in her hometown. She says she appreciates the teachers for being so caring and making opportunities available to the students. The administrators also allow us to step outside of the curriculum to make it real for the kids. We don't always have to follow a textbook. We can really tailor our learning to what the kids need and want to know. June loves keeping up with students after they graduate. Some of them contact her to look over college papers or for recommendations. To see what they've become is always fun. Some have been recognized as distinguished alumni, which makes me feel good, she says. June's married to Mentone Fire Chief Mike Hazel. They have two children together. Ethan works in animation, and Isabel is a nurse for life. So congratulations. June, anything you'd like to say?
Well, I came here in 90 and started working at Mentone, also worked at Burkitt, Datesman, worked a little bit at Akron, teaching the Gift and Talent program. When the middle school opened, then I graduated and went to the middle school for most of my time, and then just the past, 7, 8 years, I graduated and now I'm at high school. It's just been a lot of fun. Had a student come back today to visit and just to check in and see how she was doing. It was great. So I appreciate that.
Well, thank you for being a great teacher.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Congratulations. Items from the visitors. Do we have anything tonight from the visitors that they'd like to share? If not, we'll move on to D, approval of consent agenda. Number one, approve the minutes of the October 5th, 2017 executive session. Number two, approve the minutes of the October 9th, 2017 regular meeting. Number three, approve the hiring of the following personnel. Shayna Ferrucci. There you go.
Ferrucci, instructional assistant at the high school. Pam Wainscott, ECA treasurer, Mentone Elementary. Hillary Parker, high ability representative at the Akron Elementary. And Victoria
Ryder.
Yeah. Cook at the Mentone Elementary. Number four, approve the following extracurricular assignments. Leanne Ogle, 7th and 8th grade cheer coach for the middle school. Number five, accept the resignation of the following personnel. Dennis Gray, bus driver for the school corporation. Gina Campbell, health aide, Mentone Elementary. Emily Sager, instructional assistant at the Akron Elementary. Marita Powell, cook at the middle school. Casey Wise, assistant football coach for the high school. Dan Thompson, assistant football coach for the high school. Mark Gordon, soccer coach for the high school. Tiffany Krotke, girls golf coach for the high school. Lynette Shoemaker, academic team coach for the middle school. Kylie Gass, high ability coordinator at the Akron Elementary. 6, approve appointment of Randy Doms for small claims court representative. Is there anything there, fellows, that you'd like to pull out and discuss, or do I have a motion to accept?
I'll make that motion to approve the consent agenda as read by Todd.
Brian makes that motion. Do I have a second?
I can second that, Todd.
Adam seconds. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
It's passed. On to approval of claims and payroll.
Okay, thanks, Todd. We have one pre-written claim listing this evening. It's dated October the 31st of 2017 in the amount of $931,732.48. Our regular claim listing this evening is dated November 13 of 2017. It's in the amount of $192,406.62. And then we have two payrolls this evening. The first is dated October 13, 2017, in the amount of $437,634.60. The second is dated October 27, 2017, in the amount of $394,310.57. Submit these claims and payroll for your approval.
Do we have any questions on the claims and payroll? Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to accept.
Stan makes a motion to accept claims and payroll as read. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Brian seconds. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Claims and payroll pass.
Okay.
On to financial report.
All right, you have a reconciled bank statement and the monthly financial report funds for the month of October 2017. In summary, our receipts and disbursements are total receipts for all funds, $1,653,654.84. The total disbursements for all funds, $1,875,504.44.
Okay, thank you very much. On to old business. Update on the Akron Elementary School project. We're getting close to being done.
We're getting there.
Yeah.
In the last month, we've completed the units A and B painting, which includes the gym. We've completed that now since we got that wall dried out. And we've continued in the remodeled areas of the 87 wing, or unit A, we call it. And we've got the finished coat on that. And we've completed the site work for parking lots and sidewalks, and completed the interior masonry and locker room areas, and the locker rooms are probably about half painted at this time. That's on the south side of the gym, the area we kind of held off for some time to do. Completed framing and drywall, ready for their ceramic tile in the new restroom area. That's in unit A. There's a kind of a revised plan there from the original plan. Went from, I think, 4 restrooms to 2. That wasn't,
2 larger ones.
Yeah, 2 larger restrooms. And that looks a lot better and working out real well. Completed roofing in the locker room area. Completed sound panels in the gym. They're up high, about 14, 15 feet high around the perimeter. All walls has so many panels on, kind of ease the noises that, you know, echoes and such. And I've heard several comments that that is working real well, so when you go in there and you can tell. Started paving parking lots, and actually we finished paving all the parking lots today, including the front entrance there. We got that completed there by the pole.
Pole's still there.
Pole's still there, Brett.
When are they going to bring that?
Bring your chainsaw. We'll fix it. Maybe I can get Mr. Conley to do that.
I would never do anything like that.
Yeah, so that's done. We're ready for striping. That'll probably start in the next day or two in the parking lots. Mechanical areas, we continued overhead piping and ductwork in the Unit B area, as well as the A remodel area. And we continued overhead electrical rough ends in these same areas, A and B. We started sprinkler piping today in the remodeled classroom areas and Unit B locker and restroom area. We continued site lighting, and actually that was completed last week. So all light poles are now powered up, and looks pretty nice around there when you get them all on. Okay, for the next 4 weeks, we'll complete the striping that I mentioned there, and we will start demo in the phase three and the Unit A. That would be the west side of, what is there, four or five classrooms over there, or four classrooms plus the library. We will start the demo on that after Thanksgiving, when we get moved into the four that we're working on at the present time. And we'll continue painting in those areas. We should complete the grid ceiling and ceiling tile in Unit A, remodel classroom areas, and continue flooring, carpet, and tile and in those areas. Also, continue doors and hardware in Unit A. And mechanical and electrical, we'll start the plumbing in the new restroom area as soon as we get the ceramic tile on the wall. I think all those walls in that new restroom area get ceramic tile, clear to the ceiling, so we got to get that on. We should be starting that real soon. Continue overhead, mechanical, electrical in the locker room areas, and continue light fixtures throughout A and B. Complete ductwork in the gym. That's kind of what they call a sock that runs down each side of the gym up real high. And it shouldn't take them long to install that. We'll follow up that work with basketball goals. They're supposed to start Wednesday installing the six basketball goals in there. And then next week we got the floor scheduled, wood floor for the gym scheduled to come in. I'm not sure what day yet, probably Tuesday, that material will be coming in so they can get that floor started. We did do a check on that and got a little bit of touch-up to do on the floor because they do a what they call a straight-edge test, finding any humps or low spots. We got about three or four of those that we got to do some minor work on. They're only like a quarter of an inch, but don't take too much. But the guy wants it taken care of before they will install the new wood gym floor. So, and okay, we should complete the sprinkler piping in Units A and B. Should get that area ready for moving in there on right after Thanksgiving. So, I think we'll get some photos up there. That would be in one of the that's a computer room area. That's one of the newer rooms we just finished up. We're moving into those.
That's the 1987 wing, right?
That's the 87 wing there. I think there's two of those computer rooms set up like that.
The only thing that's, that hasn't changed in there are the cabinets, those are the original.
Yeah, some of the cabinets are original, and I think the wall units there, the marker boards and are new in that area, so. And of course, carpet is new in that area. Everything's new around the, that's an area we had to take all the old paint off the wall. And that's, they used dry ice, high pressure air to take the paint off, because it's a time consuming job, kind of messy, but it gets that paint off of there, so. That's one of the new restroom areas. You see the wall is, they use a special backer or to receive tile. Excuse me, the ceramic tile, it takes a special backer for that. And let's see, in the gym, looking up the goal.
Is there something acoustical up there?
I don't know what's hanging there. I can't tell what that is. It looks like it's hanging there. But that's a new scoreboard. You see all the lights are in. It's really looks good in there at the present time. The ceiling is has all sound panels, which helps on the sound and the echo that's in a lot of the gyms.
The panels that Jim was talking about on the wall are those tan ones. Those are, is that kind of like a cloth panel, Jim?
Oh, yeah, those, just below the scoreboard there. Yeah, that's
a scoreboard. Is that a cloth?
Well, yeah, it's a really vinylized, it's a fabric. It folds up in 4 foot sections back into a recessed part in the wall, back in the corner. So you can open that up for plays or anything that goes in the gym.
Let's talk about the door there.
And you can see one of the sound panels off to the right there. That's the, there's a section there about 12 foot long and 6 foot high. There's some more of those. That'd be the south end of the gym. You can see the locker room areas and an office area there with a smaller door and a window. And over to the side is the storage area for the gym. And the far left would be an outside door in the east wall in the southeast corner. That's more right in the restroom area.
That's right off the gym, right?
That's right off the gym, yeah. That's a shot of the paving we just finished up today on the east side of the gym out towards the pole barn there. And that's kind of looking south from about the same area. That is the new playground equipment that we unloaded there Friday, and was that Friday or Monday, wasn't it? It was Monday. They didn't show up to start installing today, but they're supposed to get that installed in that playground area, which is just to the south of the detention pond area, which you can see in the background there. Got a little bit of it. It's kind of hard to make out, but. And to the far left is the blacktop for the playground on the east side of D wing, and it's kind of an L-shaped section back there. That will be the new entrance area on the south side of the cafeteria and the gym. It's not completed yet. As far as the roof goes, I mean, the roof is actually on, but the coping around and the soffit there is not finished. The stone, which is precast, that you're looking at there, that's all completed. You can see in that next picture right there, I think you can see where they framed underneath, ready for sealing in that part. And all the doors for that area are also in there. You can see those aluminum doors. There are three pair of doors across there on the outside, and then inside is a lobby and another three pair of doors back there about 30 feet.
When the kids come on the buses in the morning, that's where they'll go in. They're in right there.
And that's where they're going for like concerts and basketball games. Right? Mm-hmm. A lot of parking. I drove out there Saturday.
Yes.
They're completely done, but I mean, you realize what the gym is? I mean, it's
where the old gym was?
Oh, yeah.
It's all,
wow. Compared to what they dealt with.
And that, excuse me, that is one of the remodeled rooms with the, one of the units set in there. So you see they got the piping to it, and just below the window are some, it would be closed off with new cabinets, and that's part of the ductwork or for that unit setting there. That's a drinking fountain there on the, be the south end of the 87th edition. And be the east hallway that goes north and south.
And that big restroom is right beside that, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Boys and girls restroom right to the right of that drinking fountain. That's on the west side of that corridor, and the pair of restrooms on the east side of that corridor. So. Any questions about that area?
All right,
thank you.
Okay, any other old business?
That's all.
Okay, on the new business. Initial consideration of addition to school board policy, online fundraising.
Right. Online fundraising has become an increasingly popular way for individual educators to raise funds for school-related purposes. What's called crowdfunding can be defined as a web-based service used for the solicitation of goods, services, and or money from a large number of people via the internet. The funding can be used to finance a project, business venture, or fundraise for a specific cause or charity. Examples of organizations dedicated to crowdfunding for education include DonorsChoose.org. Now, because of the fact that we have several teachers now that are acting on behalf of the school corporation in conducting online fundraising campaigns to benefit our schools, I think it's necessary for us to formulate and implement school board policy to guide those efforts. So I got a couple of sample policies from the School Board Association, tried to take the best of those and put them into our own policy, which I have provided you with a copy of. I don't know that I'm going to read through all that tonight, but do you guys have any questions about it thus far? Okay. Well, what I'll do is bring that back to you then again next month for approval. But if you have any questions between now and then, please let me know.
Sounds good. Next one, initial consideration of the 2018-19 school calendar.
Yeah. And again, this is one of those that we'll bring to you this month for your initial consideration, and then next month for action. You'll see that the 2018-2019 recommended calendar looks a lot like this year's calendar. Talking to a variety of different people, our question, was, do you like the calendar we have this year? Do you want to see some changes or not? And the folks that we talked to seem to think they like this, the calendar that we have right now. So what you have in front of you is almost identical to this year's calendar. If you start out there, you can see we've got corresponding dates for the start of the school year with teacher orientation day on Thursday, August 2nd. Staff then start on Friday, the 3rd, or that would be a staff development day. The kids would start on Monday, August the 6th. We have a couple of parent-teacher conference days built in there. on October the 11th in the fall, March 14th in the spring. Also a couple of work days on October 12th and 15th of March. Fall break would be October the 15th, and that would make that a 4-day weekend. 3 days of Thanksgiving, 21st, 22nd, 23rd. And Christmas break, we would look at 11 days for our students, so they would be out from Wednesday the 19th through Wednesday the 2nd. Our teachers would have 10 days at Christmas break. They would be out from the 19th through the 1st. Spring break would be the first week in April. Good Friday, April the 19th. And that divides up our 180 student days into semesters of 91 and 89 days. We like to keep those semesters even as closely as we can. We have 10 emergency makeup days from the last scheduled day of school until graduation on Sunday, June the 2nd. So that is a calendar that I will bring to you tonight for your to look at, and then I'll bring it back to you next month. So I'll also give you a copy of a document that looks like that, too.
Good deal. All right, on to number 3, presentation on solar project at Mentone Elementary.
Yeah, I'd like to talk to you just a little bit about the solar project here at Mentone Elementary School. And in providing a little background first, in the fall of 2014, we started looking at exploring solar energy as a means of providing electricity for our schools at Mentone and Burkett. Obviously with concerns about reductions in state funding for public schools, we just absolutely have to continually look at opportunities that will help our schools maintain our programs and our services by generating revenue in new and different ways. During that 3-year period, while the purchase price of electricity has continued to increase, the efficiencies of solar equipment have improved while the equipment costs have gone down. So, we're at a point where solar energy makes sense for Tippecanoe Valley. So what we're looking at would be installing a 44-panel solar array located on 1.5 acres of school property to the north and east of this building. It will be surrounded by a 5-foot-high fence that would prohibit public access to the equipment. We're looking at having that completed and producing electricity prior to January 1, 2018. A little bit on the how end of things. The estimated annual energy output of the 528,000 kWh solar array will be enough to power this entire school. The value of the estimated year one energy produced by the solar array will be over $70,000, with additional revenue generated by the carbon credits from the solar array. Revenue generated by the production of electricity and the carbon credits will be used to cover the annual lease payment for the solar array. At the end of 7 years, the equipment will be purchased at fair market value and will belong to the Tippecanoe Valley School Corporation. The total installed cost of the solar array is $825,000. Just to give you an idea how much the cost of that technology has gone down. When we started looking at this project 3 years ago, it was over $1 million. So it has costs have gone down. The system is being purchased from and installed by Ag Technologies of Rochester. The adjustable steel support systems for the solar panels are manufactured locally by Craig Welding. A little note here that I think obviously is pertinent to this project. Next summer, we're looking at a school-wide conversion here at Mentone to LED lighting. That's going to improve the lighting for our students and our staff. It'll also consume quite a bit less electricity. So I guess in summary, I would say that bringing solar power to Mentone is going to be a wise financial decision that really will benefit the school corporation for years to come. And I've got a couple of diagrams to show you where it will be. This is the back parking lot, which is right out here to the north. It'll be a little bit north of that in this area that's outlined in white, is where the solar array will sit. this diagram actually is a layout of what we anticipate the panels look like.
This is tied in to the grid, so if we aren't using the power, it'll go back on the grid or no?
It actually goes right to the grid.
Okay.
Yeah, it all goes to the grid, and then NIPSCO will credit us.
This is a swap.
Okay. It'll credit us for what we produce. We're going to bore underneath this parking lot back here, and up by the building, there's the equipment that we'll tie into up there. There'll be a 5-foot-high fence all the way around it. Really don't need anybody out there messing around with it, so keep them out.
And Brett, do you want to talk a little bit about the buyback, if there's any extra electricity generated?
Yeah, they credit us for anything that we produce, we get credited at the same price we pay. And it's not like the wind turbine where we use all the electricity from the wind turbine, we can use any extra we sell back, but we don't get for it as much as what we pay for electricity. With this, every bit of electricity that this produces will be sold to NIPSCO. They credit us at the exact same amount as what we pay for electricity.
And,
well, it is. It's called net metering. And it's one of the reasons why we want to get it installed by January 1, because if we do, that, by law, they're required to do that for 30 years. If we don't get it in by January 1, that number goes to, I think, 15 years. So that's one of the reasons why we wanted it by January 1st.
All right, on to the next, approval of resolutions for the Mentone Solar Project.
Okay. Attached, you guys have four resolutions that are in need of school board approval for the Mentone Solar Project. Resolution number one ratifies the appointment of appraisers, the acceptance of the report of appraisers, and approves the amount of the appraisal. The second resolution authorizes the early redemption of the bonds on November 15th, 2017, and the termination of the lease. Resolution number three approves the general terms of a purchase agreement and sale of real estate. And resolution number four authorizes the finalization and approval of service contract or similar agreement and related documents relating to the use of electricity produced by the solar array and a consent to collateral assignment agreement. Consent to collateral assignment agreement is the Tippecanoe Valley's consent to assign its benefits, but it's not its obligations to the lender if Tippecanoe Valley would default on its obligations. What we're looking for at this point is approval of those resolutions, and you guys have those resolutions.
Any other questions?
I'll make that recommendation to approve the resolutions 1, 2, 3, and 4 as presented to us by Mr. Bog.
Brian makes that motion. Do I have a second?
I can make that motion, Todd.
Adam makes that motion. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it.
Okay. Then you also have an item that we did not get put on the agenda, but it's a board report regarding the approval of a motion for the Mentone Solar Project. And our attorney has asked me to have you guys approve this. It says, I move that the board officers, administration, and legal counsel be authorized to negotiate and finalize the terms of an access easement in the form of the easement presented to this meeting, and the board president and secretary to execute the easement once finalized. And you've got a copy of that document there. So what we need tonight is board to approve that motion
also. Do I have a motion to approve the more or less easement? Correct, more or less, is what you'd call it. Approval. Sample access easement agreement. So, do I have a motion to
approve? Yeah, a motion, Todd, to accept that.
Stan makes that motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
And Brian seconds. All in favor by saying aye.
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 The ayes have it.
Okay.
So now we are Number five, approval of resolution to deposit local income tax into the general fund.
Right, the local option income tax school distribution is no longer fund-specific, so it can be deposited into any fund the school corporation chooses. The budget that we approved for 2017 called for the deposit of the local income tax into debt service, capital projects, transportation, and bus replacement into those funds and the amounts indicated. What we're asking the board tonight is to approve the resolution to deposit that local income tax into the general fund.
Do you have any other questions about them? Do I have a motion?
I'll make that motion to approve that.
Brian makes the motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
And Adam seconds. All in favor by saying aye?
Aye.
Aye.
Ayes have it. On to approval of tentative agreement with the Tippecanoe Valley Classroom Teachers Association.
I'm pleased to share with the board that we've reached an agreement with our Tippecanoe Valley Classroom Teachers Association on a master contract for 2017-2018. We reached that on October the 23rd. The teachers, I think, approved that last Thursday night, June. So I'm going to ask the board to also approve the agreement this evening, and I'll just give you a bit of a summary here of what it entails. The biggest thing in this year was taking our salary schedule and making it comply with the requirements of the Indiana Education Employment Relations Board. They had some guidelines in place that we had to make sure that we were in compliance with, so that was the major focus this year. There were no insurance increase, no increase in health insurance premium. We did agree to equalize an equalizing stipend of $250 for anybody that would receive $250 or less in the transition in the new schedule. There were some people that were a little under that, but some people were quite a bit more than that, but we felt that everybody should at least get that much. We talked about adding a 403B provider, or adding the Roth IRA to the options for the 403B. We have met with our MetLife representative. That's something that we're going to go ahead and be able to do. Something the teachers requested that I think will be beneficial to several of them. We negotiated a buyback of the amount of unused sick leave days. Right now, we pay $60 a day for those. We agreed to $70 a day, which is the same as the buyback rate on personal days. In trade for that, we agreed to the fact that teachers who leave and owe days back to the sick leave bank. So if you borrowed sick leave days, you leave, you haven't paid all those back. When it comes time to pay them back, they'll pay them back at their daily rate rather than the sub rate. And that is effective with this year's contract, the 17-18 contract. Anybody that's borrowed days before that would be grandfathered. Expanded criminal history checks, as you guys are well aware, we have to do those every 5 years now for every employee. So once someone is employed by Tippecanoe Valley, we will not require them to pay for a second criminal history check. Corporation will take care of that. We agreed to a one-year contract, and something we talked about potentially more than 1 year, but with funding being so unpredictable, we felt just weren't really comfortable doing that. And then the last thing here is the 403B contribution. When you reach your fourth year with Tippecanoe Valley, it was a matching contribution of up to $1,050. That has increased now, is $1,100. So those are the basics of the agreement. If you guys are okay with that, we'll have you approve that, and then we've got a contract tonight that we need the president and secretary signature on. We'll get it signed tomorrow by Mr. Shriver and Mrs. Hazel, and we'll have a contract this year.
Any questions? Spelled out pretty good. Do I have a motion to agree the tentative agreement for the Classroom Teachers Association?
Todd, I'll make that motion as read.
Adam makes that motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Dan seconds. All in favor by saying aye?
Aye.
The ayes have it.
That's all I have.
Good deal. We're on to Cheyenne and Bryce. How's things going at the high school?
They've been going good. We had the National FFA convention, and that went good. And the high school had their play, too, which I didn't go, but I heard it. I heard some good things about it. And then the Student Council State Convention, they just had that. Then the FFA Area Forestry Contest is November 20th. Then also, kind of further down the road, the high school has a blood drive December 1st.
Also, girls basketball, as you know, just started, and that's going really well. They're off to a good start, and boys have started practicing. Also, Thanksgiving break coming up, of course. A thing that Student Council does every year, we always bring in, our members bring in different foods, Thanksgiving foods, and we'll provide meals for 5 different families within the corporation, so that's kind of a way to give back to the community, which is really cool. Also, we recently had a Herf Jones representative come to the high school for students to talk about caps and gowns, so it was kind of a bittersweet realization for seniors that the time's coming, so that was pretty cool, but that's about it, cool on right now. So.
Thank you much. Well, I believe if no one else has anything, we're adjourned for the evening. Thanks for coming.